Good morning, madam.
Principal, welcome to our institution. I know a little Telugu. Swagatam. Very happy to have you in our institution, sir.
Thank you, madam. It's my pleasure.
Sir, where is this college of yours, sir, in Andhra?
So it was at Rajahmundry, madam, near Godavari Bridge. So it was Godavari Institute of Engineering and Technology near Rajahmundry.
No, for some time I worked in Vijayawada.
All right. Okay.
East Ala College. I worked, but I don't know much of Telugu, sir. A few words I will manage.
Okay.
Have you here, sir?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dhanyavadalu, right?
Dhanyavadalu. Exactly.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, we shall start the session within few minutes, sir, if you don't mind, please.
Yeah, please. Let's wait for a couple of minutes and then we will go.
Sure, all right, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you. Principal ma'am, Maithili madam, shall we start, ma'am? Madam principal, shall we begin the session, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. If all the students have come, we can start in participants.
Yes, ma'am. It's getting late, actually.
I know.
So
you can start, ma'am. I'm willing to
listen.
Though I might not understand a lot of physics, it doesn't matter.
Yes, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Sir, good morning. Thank you for accepting my invitation, because I had already joined your FDP program conducted by Godavari Institute last May. So after listening to your talk, I was much impressed and I thought that it will be beneficial to our students also. So thank you for accepting our invitation. Thank you for joining this online conference. And I call upon Sudarshana, madam, from Department of Physics of PKR Arts College to take over this session now. Sudarshana, please. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Rise up, start fresh. See the bright opportunity in each new day. Every day may not be good, but there is something good in every day. A very pleasant morning, one and all present here. I am Ms. R. Sudarshana, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics. On behalf of PKR Arts College for Women Autonomous Gobi Chetty Palayam, I extend a very warm welcome to all the dignitaries, staff members, research scholars, and students who are all present in this virtual platform on the day 2 of the National Conference on Advanced Functional Materials and Engineering. And without any delay, let us begin our session. Excellence is not being the best, it is doing your best. May I now request Ms. N. Subhatra ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, to welcome and introduce the speaker of the session.
Good morning to one and all present here. I welcome you all for the second day, third session of the National Conference on Advanced Functional Materials and Engineering. organized by the Department of Physics, PKR College for Women. A warm welcome to our resource person of this session, Dr. Sharat Chandra Virla, Associate Professor, Department of Humanities and Basic Sciences, Godavari Institute of Engineering and Technology, Rajahmundry, Andhra Pradesh, who is here to throw some lights on controlled nano-sized bioceramics for biomedical applications. We welcome you, sir. Thank you for accepting our invitation. I am delighted to welcome our secretary and correspondent, Thirupiyan Venkatachalam, sir, and it's my pleasure to extend a glad welcome to our beloved CEO, Madam Professor Jagada Lakshmanan, a cordial welcome to our respected principal, Madam Dr. D. Maithili, and I extend a cheerful welcome to our vice principal and controller of examinations, Mrs. S.A. Dhanlakshmi, Madam. And it gives me immense pleasure to welcome Dr. V. Ratika, Head of Department of Physics, and all the faculty members of physics who are organizing this program. And to the participants of today's session, faculty members, research scholars, and students who are connected with us today through Zoom meeting platform and YouTube Live, I am delighted to welcome you all today. Now, it's my privilege to give a brief introduction about our research person, Dr. Sharat Chandra Virla. Sir has completed his UG in Acharya Nagarjuna University, Andhra Pradesh. He did his PG in VIT University, Vellore, PhD in Anna University, Chennai, both in Tamil Nadu. Sir has continued his research as a postdoctoral fellow in Department of Applied Science and Technology, Politecnico di Torino, Italy, and as a research associate too in Department of Aerospace Engineering, IISc, Bangalore. Then he worked as a research professor in Photonic Nanomaterials Laboratory, Chosun University, Gwangju, South Korea, and in Biofunctional Polymers Laboratory, Cheongnam National University, Daejeon, South Korea. Presently, Sir has been working as an associate professor in Godavari Institute of Engineering and Technology, Andhra Pradesh. So it is obvious that he has a vast experience in both research and academics. His areas of research are biomaterials, synthesis of nanoparticles for hyperthermia treatment and its drug delivery, defluoridation from groundwater using different sorbents. His instrumentation skills include UV visible spectrophotometer, optical microscope, zeta potential measurement, contact angle measurement, etc. Sir has published 26 articles in most reputed journals. Some of them are in collaboration with researchers from various countries. Sir has filed a patent for medium for the removal of fluoride from water and also published 2 book chapters in Springer Publishers. He is a reviewer in international journals like Journal of Alloys and Compounds, Archives of Oral Biology and Material Science and Engineering of Elsevier, and Journal of Biomaterial Series, Polymer Edition of Taylor and Francis Online. Sir has organized a few FDPs and conferences and also delivered some guest lectures. Sir has attended many FDPs and presented papers in many international conferences and awarded for best presentations in a few. Sir has been awarded National Doctoral Fellowship by AICTE India from 2009 to 2012 for the sum of ₹7.23 lakhs. Senior Research Fellowship by CSIR India from 2012 to 2013 for ₹3.46 lakhs and Erasmus Mundus Postdoctoral Fellowship from 2013 to 14 for the fund of €18,000. Sir is a lifetime member of Society of Biomaterials and Artificial Organs. We are fortunate enough to have such an eminent personality for today's session. Now, I request Sir to take over the session.
Yeah, thank you, madam. Thank you for your introduction. So it's my pleasure to have to be here in this web platform. So during this pandemic situation, like, so sir, otherwise we can, yeah.
Excuse me, sir. This is the CEO of the college, Jagda Lakshmanan.
Yeah, please, ma'am.
Welcome you.
Yes. You have accepted our invitation. You are very kind of you to accept our invitation. I'm sure you will have a nice time presenting your points. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Welcome to you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank you, principal madam, and thank you, Radhika ma'am. Sir, thank you each and everyone.
Thank you, sir.
So shall I start the session, yes, madam?
Sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, please, sir.
Yeah. So it's a warm a kind of thing, like which I can say that as I gave, it's pleasure to be here in this web platform. So unfortunately during this pandemic situation, otherwise we can have a good time at your institutes and or else in our institutes to organize and conferences, such kind of things to be here. Unfortunately, during this pandemic COVID situation, we can't do anything so here now I'm as I have passed one decade, I was working on the biomaterials. So since these nanoparticles, which can be used for the drug delivery applications and targeted drug delivery applications, all these things, this is my research area. As I had my vast experiences in the abroad as well as in India, so recently in the last year which I came here to join as an associate professor at Godavari Institute of Engineering and Technology, so as an associate professor. And then here I was, we have a lab which was developed with nanomaterials for a photovoltaic and biomaterials laboratory. So with those collaborations which we are doing, a very good work which in at our organization also, and publications as well as few publications and as well as so coming to this, my so research area, this was my research area which I was doing on that controlled nano-sized bioceramics. So what is bioceramics? Ceramic materials which we can use for the bone implantation materials, teeth implantation materials. This ceramics which have the biological properties, that is much more important for this. So ceramic material which should contain the biological properties so that which we can mimic inside our body. So that will be called as the biomaterials. And there were several biomaterials which we have implantation, bioimplants. So as we have some accident and all those things occurs, so they will implant those titanium alloys and all those things. Titanium is the best bio-inert material which we can implant inside our body and all those things. So as well as we have heart walls, artificial heart walls, which we can made up of this bioceramic materials, so which has done at the Sri Chitra Tirunal Thiruvananthapuram. So they are developing with artificial heart walls by using these bioceramic materials. And knee implantation, joint replacements, and all those things, as we know about the. And what we do is this titanium material, bio implant materials, bio metals. So these biometals, which we can coat on the surface with the ceramic materials, bioceramic material, so that the cells, human body cells, blood cells, all these things that can adhere on the surface of those biomaterials, so that it can easily mimic inside our body. So that's what the beauty of this bioimplantation materials and all. And mostly which we have some of those diseases dental fluorosis, skeletal fluorosis, and bone deficiency, osteoporosis. And one more disease which is called as osteosarcoma. Osteosarcoma is nothing but a bone cancer. So all these things, these are things which we can cure with the bio-nano materials. So nanoceramics, which we can synthesize those bioceramic material, so that can cure these bio diseases, bone diseases and other diseases. And some of the applications which we have, as I said, so hypothermia. Hypothermia is nothing but usually our body temperature will be 37 degrees Celsius. So when we go with this metal doped ceramics inside our body, when we mimic with these nanoparticles, so that will produce, instead of external heat, a magnetic field. So by making with the magnetic field, that can, these metal nanoparticles can generate the heat till up to it will reach just 43 degrees Celsius. Like. And then, and also these biomaterials, which we can use for the water treatment, like as we have the water treatment, so that bio means as we have biologically also, which we can use these materials. And so that which we can absorb those fluorine content, which was contained into our groundwater, as well as arsenic also. Arsenic, due to the arsenic, as we see, is like Bangladesh and Bangladesh, near Bangladesh. So due to the arsenic, so they are causing with several diseases like skin cancer and all those kind of cancers, which was occurring due to the arsenic content, excess of intake of arsenic content, which was in our groundwater and all those things. To remove those arsenic, fluoride and all those things, we can use these biomaterials, bioceramic materials, so that which we can absorb those, which they can absorb those arsenic materials, metal ions, fluoride contents in the groundwater, so that which we can pure water up to the 92% of pure water which we can obtain in this groundwater. So these are all the some of the areas which are of my research area, so which we had published in the ACS Applied Materials and Material Science and Engineering and several other journals. Like, so what we had is like, so basically this ceramic which is containing in the spherical morphology, which we can see in the TEM morphology, TEM analysis. So TEM, through TEM analysis, which we have a spherical size in shape like. And slowly these spherical shape, which we can changing in the morphology of a rod-like morphology. So which, while doping into the metal ions in that ceramic materials, right? So when we keep doping of these concentration, different concentration of metal ions, so what the morphology is being changing from spherical to rod-like morphology. And also, so basically this ceramic material, some of these ceramic materials, I will especially focus on the calcium phosphate material. Calcium phosphate is like bone and teeth. So mostly it occurs in the bone and teeth material. So basically this calcium phosphate, which will be in the diamagnetic property. So which doesn't contain any magnetic properties. Like, and when we keep doping these metal ions, so as of the ferromagnetic property of metal ions, like iron, cobalt, nickel, and all those metal ions, so this diamagnetism to a ferromagnetism, super paramagnetic property, it will reach us like. So when we keep increasing those things, concentration and all those things, so what we observe is like these super paramagnetic material, which can cure the cancer as well as the hypothermia treatment. Like. So most probably, which can cure the bone cancer and all those things. And also for the drug delivery applications. So at that particular targeted site, so which we can drag these magnetic nanoparticles at a particular site, so which we can reach it, say that as a targeted drug delivery. Like. So morphology and all those kind of things like, so different metal ions which I had incorporated in those things and how the drug has been releasing at that particular site and all. So that we had observed through the UV spectroscopy measurement. So most probably I'll generally talk about all these things with the basic knowledge of, since it will be most easier to do much concentrate on the research area for the beginners and all. So I would like to focus only on those areas like. Coming to the next, and also which we are doing at the current lab at the Nano NPBL lab. We can say here at the Godavari Institute of Technology. So we'll say that lab as an NPBL lab. Like. So here we are doing also with the energy harvesting material. Like. So through the piezoelectric property and all those things. So those, one of my colleagues, Dr. Ashtagal Anil Kumar, A. Anil Kumar, is also doing with the, extensively we are working on the research. And by basic funding, since we had applied some of the external funding with the DST as well as DPT. So maybe soon we will get the call from them like for those panel selection and all those things like. So what we are also doing, this piezoelectric material, so through this to generate the energy. So for example, I can say simply like, so when we are walking on the, traveling on the road, so by car, either by lorry or whatever that. So by generating this stress on that platform road, so these roads will be the energy electrode, piezoelectric material. So most probably, which we can see recently, it was doing on the Japan technology. Like, so they are started doing with that. So with the more efficient energy saving, so that we generate the energy by street lights, by beside those roads and all, we will have the street lights over there on the roads, like to generate those electricity, to harvest those energy and to give more electricity to the street lights and other other thing, kind of things like also. So this is one more area which we are doing in that area also, like. And coming to this minimum basic knowledge, which I just want to give that what is nanomaterial, what is nano size, as we know that the 10 power minus 9 and all. So this nanotechnology, which we can vast area, which we electronics, electricals, as well as the biomedical, cosmetic, agriculture, food industries, textile industry, this nanotechnology has been used in that. This is the variation of that nanoparticles, a size variation of different like biologically, mainly focus, I just want to focus on the biological. So that's what I'll focus on the virus and like coronavirus also. As I had one more picture of the tea. Virus and all those things. So normally in general, like this virus, which will be around the 100 nanometers and all. The bacteria, which will be containing 0.10, 10 power minus 3 millimeter range, nanometer range and all those things. Right? Even in the blood cells. So blood cells, as well as the cancer cell, which we inside our body, which we contains a different kind of cells, like kidney cells, bone marrow cells, and cancer cells, and different kind of cells which will be containing with the point or not 1 millimeter range it will be. So that's what we will opt with the optical microscope. Basically, for biological people, while they do with the in vitro means like laboratory level. When we do the analysis with this nano-sized material, in vitro level, like a laboratory scale, that will be called as in vitro level. And when we go with the in vivo, so that in vivo will be called as when we inject inside any mouse, most probably they'll do with the mouse, or even in the human trials and all those things. Like. So for in vivo and all, we should contain the ethical committee and all that. The government should approve those ethical committee and all those things. Like. So because of this in vitro and in vivo, once we success in that, so that's what this, to invent this medicine for the coronavirus, it was taking months and months. Hardly we just started with during this year's January in India, especially in India, it started the. And the revolution, like the researchers started inventing the new medicine through this area. It was taking months and months due to this in vitro level. Initially, they'll do this nanoparticles or medicine, whatever, in the in vitro level, laboratory scale. And then we'll go with the in vivo and then with the human trials and all those. So this situation, this period and all, it will take more than like 6 month period and all. So that's what it will take like. So that's what we need to be very careful with during this pandemic situation. And coming to this sheet of the paper, DNA and all those things, all you know, like kind of things. Like. And coming to this slide, which I would like to know, so even in the nature also, so nature will also automatically, ultimately, they will have the nanotechnology. So when we go with the lizards, so how the lizards will stick on the valve and all like. So because the body weight of that lizard, even the Superman, some of the Spider-Man and all, they will stick with the one hand on the which you can see the beside that Superman is. So how they are standing? So they will have the on the feet fenders, like kind of hand and all those. So nano, a gel kind of things. Yeah. So that due to that nano gel, which we can stuck with the on the wall, even on the mirror also. So even on the mirror also, what they'll do, even the lizard and all the other kind of things, they can run like anything, like. So even slippery kind of thing at that area. So due to this nanotechnology only, fiber kind of nanotechnology only, they can only withstand on the wall and all those things. So they have the dry adhesive type of material, which you can on the hands of that legs of those lizard and all those things. And these are all the different classification of materials, zero dimensional material, one dimensional, how the two dimensional material looks like, and also with the three dimensional nano materials, how the structure has been made. So most probably a zero dimension, which will be called as a spherical shape. So what we can, there is no shape for the those x-axis and y-axis for the zero dimensional. Sphere and all those kind of things, there is, when there is no shape in that, that dimension will be called as zero dimensional kind of thing. Then we go with the one dimensional life. So that for the zero dimensional, which we can say that quantum dots and hollow cubes and all kind of things. And coming to the one dimensional, nanowires and nanorods, the kind of things which we can say. Coming to the two dimensional nanofibers. So as I found in the calcium phosphate, when we dove with those different metal structure, so which we had observed a flakes kind of things like. So with the, those material, when we incorporate with the silver content. So when we dove with this silver content inside the calcium phosphate material, we had observed through the TEM and SEM analysis through the flakes shape of morphology. That will be comes under the two dimensional. Spheres, hollow spheres, like mesoporous kind of things. Where these mesoporous will observe, like when we have the bone, so inside that bone, what they will do is like they will porous, without the porous structure, the blood cells and all, it cannot travel inside that bone material. So this porous structure is very, very important for this three-dimensional material. And coming to this shape, so as I said, three-dimensionally and all those, when we observe this material under transmission electron microscopy or scanning electron microscopies and all that. So this and all which we can observe. So zero-dimensional, how it looks like under the traveling microscope, microscope which we can see over those pictures. And coming to the cobalt ferrite. So cobalt ferrite core shell structure and all comes under the zero dimensional structure and all. Coming to the one dimensional, which we have the nano wires and nano rods and fiber kind of things, which will comes under the one dimensional kind of things. So most probably iron doped. So as I had published in the ACS applied materials. So that will, as I said, like a rod like morphology, when we dope this iron content into the calcium phosphate material. So that will be containing with the rod-like morphology kind of things. And coming to the two-dimensional. So what is two-dimensional? So whatever the nano branches, plates, walls, a disc, all comes under this two-dimensional. Two-dimensional is when these having axis and y-axis, like kind of thing, which will be called as a two-dimensional kind of thing. And coming to the nano balls and comes under the three-dimensional morphology kind of things like. So that recently, which was published, which I had took this from the manganese ferrite and magmite. So magnemite and this kind of things, iron oxide, which will be mostly used for the targeted drug delivery applications. And these are all the various applications which I already said with these nanomaterials, carbon nanoparticles, which will have used in the biosensors and drug delivery applications. So MNP means magnetic nanoparticles, like which will be having magnetic nanoparticles, cobalt ferrite and as well as iron oxides, magmite, and all this comes under the magnetic nanoparticles, like. And the composites kinds of thing. Composites means which we can composite material, two materials which we can mix together, like. So that composites, so those materials will also, mostly the composites, what they will do is ball milling and all mechanically they will start grinding those through this ball milling and all other things, and they will reduce these composite materials to the nano size, and by nano size various application they can do all this. And then this is morphology, which we can say that the various virus kind of thing. Mostly I just want to focus on those biologically, so how the naturally things has been occurring in the naturally, as well as things has been made by the human made, how the nano size has been we can see under the microscope of those sizes of blood vessels, viruses, and all those things. And similarly, how the gallium nitride and all those things, they will do the synthesis with the different MOCVD techniques and all those kind of things. So, and then they will do with those different kind of analysis they can do. So this is the slide which we had, which I had worked at the South Korea. So which we had worked with the human HeLa cells. HeLa cells is nothing but with the human vesicle cells, as well as with the bone cancer cells, MG63 cells, kind of things, like. So what we had found is like, so which we had coated with this silica nanoparticle. Silica SiO2 will have the very huge band gap. So when we coat with this material with the biological material, so core structure which we coat this silicon oxide material SiO2 with the calcium phosphate kind of things, and then slowly which we can bioimaging property. So this bioimaging property which we can go and which we can trace out those silicon nanoparticles, and then say there we can find out it can reach at the particular breast cancer cells and all those things. So at that particular site which we can target those materials. And coming to this nano size synthesis and all those things, like, which we have the top down process and top bottom up approaches. Like top to down means like basically which we have a bulk material, so they used to do with the ball milling and all those kind of things, and after that they make it pure grinding with the nano sized, and then that will be called as a top to down approach. And when we go with the bottom-up approach, means nothing but like the chemical synthesis, like sol gel method and hydrothermal method, from the chemically route, which we can synthesize this, and then after gelation, formation of gelation and all those things, and then we can get the precipitate through the wet chemical method and all those things. So through chemically, which will be called as a bottom-up approach. So that's what we can, I had started with the arrow as yellow as a top to bottom, and then bottom to up approach, like. And different kind of types of how the kind materials which we go with the synthesize those top to down approach of those material, bulk material by milling and thermal cycling, annealing property, and then after that ball milling which we can observe. And also UV lithography. So this lithography which we can do with the next slides, I just done with the fluidics, microfluidics and all those kind of things, like. So microfluidics through the lithography technique on photolithography technique, which we had synthesized on the silicon wafers. So we will create those channels, and then after that we'll keep some of the chemical material on those channels, and then we will make the a nano-sized materials, channels inside that. So that in the next slides, I can discuss those things much in the next slides. And this is the bottom-up approach, is nothing but like chemical-chemical, pi-pi interactions and super molecular interactions, and due to the Van der Waals interaction, these bottom approaches, like chemical route, it will occur through this bottom-up approaches, like. So as I said, like electrically, chemical, biochemical, temperatures, and all those kind of things. Like, and these are all the different methods or techniques which we can synthesize the materials in the nano size. Like, so through the liquid phase as well as the gaseous phase. So most probably this MOCVD techniques, chemical vapor deposition techniques, MOCVDs comes under the through the chemical. They will go with the what they will do with this gas, helium gas and all those nitrogen gas. So ammonia gas and all they will keep on passing in that chamber. So CVD chamber, and then keep reducing those nano size material and all those things like that. And coming to the liquid phase, as I said, like a sol gel technique, as well as a wet chemical meta analysis, which we can synthesize those nanoparticle sizes. So these are all, since those are beginners only, which I can discuss all those things. As we know about the sol gel, like, so sol means solution, as well as the gelation. What they will do is like, by making the different solvents. If you use as a water as a solvent, so that will be called as a chemical route method. Like, so when we go with the alkyls, like ethanol and methanol and kind of things, alcohols, when we use those kind of alcohols, that will be called during the synthesis, so we will get the gelation formation. Like, so that's what a solution as well as the gel kind of things. The both they will mix together, that will be called as sol gel method kind of thing. And coming to the hydrothermal technique, which I had mostly focused during my research area, which I was done at Anna University and R.S. Narayan Kalkura. So without his guidance and whatever, like, so I will not be here, like, nowhere, like, so due to his guidance and all those kind of things, right? So what we have. So guru, he is my guru, like Kalkura, which we used to synthesize these nanoparticles. Even, you know, like if we synthesize this nanomaterial, hydroxyapatite, which we, the yield of this material, which we can obtain only the, like, not less than 10 grams, like, kind of things. So what we do is, like, we had an, patent, which we had, Indian patent, which we had filed a patent. So those during this, so we have to do the ground analysis also. So for ground analysis means, like, we have the collaboration with the Annamalai University people. And what they do is, like, they will take 2 kgs of this synthesized nanoparticle material. And then what they will do is they will mix in the groundwater. Like, they collect those with the different, mainly in the Tamil Nadu area, there were different areas, like, so different areas, they will collect the groundwater, and then they will analyze this content of fluorine content. So what beauty is that in this hydrothermal synthesized calcium phosphate material, so they got a very much very good efficiency, up to the 92% of efficiency, which has been observed the almost fluorine content into that from that groundwater. Like, so that's what, so I used to keep on synthesize this material of cages, like, kind of things, even in the day and morning kind of things, like. And then we will give it to the Annamalai people. They will do the ground analysis and all this. And then for one single analysis, we are not at all satisfied. Like, no, whether this material can be used or not. Like, then again, we'll go with the Delhi, JNU Delhi. We have the collaboration with the Chidambaram at JNU University, Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. Like, again, we have the collaboration with the environmental science department, like, so with another professor, and the same analysis with that, which we obtained a similar analysis, which was matching with the Annamalai University as well as the Jawaharlal Nehru University. Then we started filing the patent with those analysis, like, so those like calcium and phosphate material, as well as calcium as a source, nitrate material, and for diammonium phosphate as a phosphate as a source, like, we'll mix together, and then we will keep it in the hydrothermal method, and then up to the, we will build up some pressure and kind of things, heat and all, and the heat and pressure that will develop this nano sized particle, which we can observe in the spherical shape morphology kind of. So this GM analysis also, which we can observe, like, those men. And coming to the other, which we had, photopolymerization. So what is photopolymerization like? So during the UV photo analysis, so this synthesis also, which we can observe this shape of those scaffold materials. So what is scaffold? Scaffold materials means nothing but like, so for example, which skin patches like, so mostly skin has been burned. So fire accident and all, like our skin is having the burn some patches kind of things. So what we synthesize is we will develop the bio scaffold material, and then we will keep those, we will test with the in vitro as well as the in vivo level, and then only we'll go with what this, we can mimic this same bio scaffold material inside that, and then we can synthesize biomimic this material through the photopolymerization technique also. So this also, which we had done and we had published in the material science and engineering. And coming to the biosensor, this is another kind of electrodes which we can synthesize during those coating analysis. Like, so while coating electrodes, two electrodes, a positive electrode and negative electrode, and these ions, whatever the positive ions as well as the negative ions. So when I done with the analysis at Chungnam National University, mainly we focus on this area. Like, so what we have is we will take with the different substrate materials, like as we did with the glass material, normal glass material, as well as the titanium, as well as SS. SS is nothing but like a steel material, even the steel rods as well as the titanium rods which we take and implant them. So there, which we do with these two electrodes, we will dip in that, and then whatever the positive ions, basically this calcium is nothing but in the positive ion. Like, so this positive ion will go and adhere at the surface of those material at that titanium material, and then again we'll go with the electrode of the negative electrode, and then again we'll, after adhering this calcium material, so automatically what the negative ion will do, so negative will positive and negative, positive and negative, like that we will layer by layer we will coat on the substrate materials, and then later on after coating those material we will do with the laboratory in vitro analysis of those drug release and all those kind of work. So this is the area which we have recently sent on the SES to those material of synthesizes sensor kind of material. So biosensor, which we can, this is a simple example which I had. I just want to, don't want to reveal all my results, which since this has not had been published, like. So, but some of those points I can discuss, like. So some of the simple example is like blood glucose kind of analyze, those kind of things, this bio kind of sensors has been used. And coming to this analysis, so we had synthesized those material, nanomaterial, how, what we had, whether the my material is in the nano size, whether this material is in the micro size, we don't know, like. So to analyze those materials, we have different techniques like XRD. So XRD, we couldn't find out those size morphology and all those things, but we can analyze the phase structure. So as we know that like crystal structure, so whether this crystal structure is in the FCC, face-centered cubic shape, or in the BCC shape, hexagonal, tetragonal, all this kind of morphology analysis which we can synthesize, which we can analyze through the XRD analysis, X-ray diffraction analysis. And then this crystallite size, which we can see under through a microscope, a scanning microscope, FSM analysis and all kind of things. So this grain size and all those things which we can observe on them. And coming to the particle size and all, like, so what is DLS? DLS is nothing but dynamic light scattering. Through the scattering of the light and all, we can scattered light, so that has been detected. The scattered light has been detected through the detector, and there we can analyze the, we can get the peak of those material, and during the phase shape of that, size of that material, how much it has been observed, we can see through the DLS analysis kind of things. And this is the XRD, as you know that phase morphology, which I had, this is the one more material, which I had done with the different copper doped hydroxyapatite. So hydroxyapatite is nothing but the calcium phosphate material. So this cobalt doped material, which we have like a different phases has been dual phase. So which we can say like cobalt oxide also observed, as well as the calcium phosphate phase also observed. Both has been combined together, and which we get the that's what, when these combined together, we got the super paramagnetic property in the VSM analysis, like vibrating sample magnetometer. There we can find out the magnetic properties and all those kind of things. And coming to the scanning electron microscope, what as we know that the size of the analysis which we can measure through the scanning electron microscope and all those things. So there the X-rays and will fall on those beam of those material, surface of that material, that it, they will eject on that material. That ejected surface we can detect through the detectors and all kind of thing. The similar kind of things with the advanced technology, which is nothing but the TEM analysis, transmission electron microscopy kind of things. So that we can see, observe the less than 1-2 nanometer range also we can observe through this transmission electron microscopy line. So whatever we synthesize those material, so sol gel, gel technique and all those things. And after that we will fine powder and all those things, we will make it the fine powder material. And that fine powder material will keep under the microscope material. This is some of those TEM pictures of my published papers. Like they have, we have SEM analysis, which will be observed as a spherical morphology kind of things, like. And slowly, slowly, when we go dope with those metal ions and all, so their hexagonal structure, which we can see here, there will be an hexagonal shape. So basically, this cubic structure and all those things, like. So when we dope with these metal ions, so slowly this hexagonal shape. So calcium phosphate. So as I said, hydroxyapatite, which will be in the hexagonal shape, like. So that we can analyze through the XRD analysis. So there we can find out, and what we had observed is porous kind of thing, structure like. So you can see, observe that G, figure G. So what it says that like even our bone marrow, when we break in that bone marrow, we can see those porous structure kind of material like. So through the porous structure only, these drugs, whatever the drugs which we can inject inside our body, through those porous only, it will travel inside our whole bone marrows and all, whole body and all. So through this porous structure also, which we can observe. Like. So as I said, like a corona structure. So till last year, we don't know what is corona and all those kind of things. Like people are started in researching with what is this, what was the shape of those material, what was the structure of those things. So what there we found out, so this has been recently published, I just took from there. So one of the paper of the Journal of Medical Research paper, and there the structure they had found, it was normally they had observed it will be around the 10 nanometer range, like kind of things. So there were there even more also, like, so they started searching with the TEM analysis of those coronavirus and all those kind of things. As I said, like a DLS analysis, DLS, dynamic light scattering, like. So what in that, so we have the cuvette and kind of things, we'll keep those things in the solvent of methanol or ethanol, this nanoparticle, we will disperse in that cuvette, and then we will keep inside that. And there at one particular area, the one side, the light, laser light has been falling on that cuvette. And then whatever the scattered light, the particle, whatever that late light scatters on the nanoparticle, there some of those light has been ejected from there. Scattering has been occurred at that particular place. So due to that scattering process, so that scattered light, so that has been detected by the detector, and there we can say size as well as the intensity we can measure. So there we can see the size of the morphology, size of that a nanoparticle. And even zeta-sizer means like, so whether these, what is nothing but zeta-sizer means, so as I synthesize this material, So this material will have been containing the surface negativity or the surface positivity. So that has been seen under through this zeta potential analysis. So we will have the electrode over there and we'll dip those electrodes, and then there we'll get the negativity or the surface positivity we can observe in that. And coming to the vibrating sample magnetometer, which we had done at the IIT Madras, so there we have advanced technology, sophisticated analysis there. So there, as I done with the calcium material as a diamagnetic property, as well as the super paramagnetic property, kind of magnetic properties, which I has done in there. And hardness. So hardness, what hardness plays a major role for the bone kind of material, kind of things like. So because if it is brittle kind of things, so there is no use of keeping those material inside our body, mimic inside our body kind of things like. So the hardness and all, it will be having contained more and more. So that hardness, Vickers hardness, which I had done at the Madras University. So University of Madras. So by using this analyzer, Vickers hardness testing. So what they will do is they will keep applying the loads, different kind of loads on that material. For example, this is my substrate material. So this is my substrate material, which I had titanium coated on the surface. So when I inject, when I keep the load, weight of 10 grams, 20 grams, 30 grams kind of things, so there will be a diagonal shape of kind of things has been occurred. Indenter will be occur at that surface. Through those indenters and all, we can measure the hardness of that material. So this ultraviolet, as we know that UV waves, which we can observe those drug analysis. So drug, what we'll do is, in general, we have in market, so there was several drugs has been observed, available in that line. So what we'll do is, mainly I had focused on the antibiotics as well as the cancer drugs. Right? So antibiotics is nothing but the amoxicillin, gentamicin and all kind of this material which I had been taking, and also as well as with the anti-cancer is nothing but the 5-fluorouracil. So these are all the different kinds of cancer drugs which has been available in the market. So those available drugs which we will buy through the market, and then what we'll do is whatever we have synthesized material, so we'll mix these drugs in that. So how that drug has been released, whether it has been rapidly released, rapidly means very fast it has been released, or whether it has been released very sustainedly, or it has been released like a pulsed manner, and all these things we can study through this UV visible spectroscopic kind of things. So initially we'll take those drugs, and then with different aliquots we will make different concentration of this, like 10 ppm, 20 ppm, 30 ppm, like kind of solution we will synthesize. We will make those solutions with a different kind of ratios, and then we will keep under the microscope, UV visible spectroscopy, and then there we will observe the absorbance value, and at different absorbance value we will keep the standard graph. And based on the standard graph, we will measure the whether the drug has been released very fast, whether the drug has been released very rapid or not, we will check in the UV waves. So these are all my published things which I has been published recently in those standard graphs, which look like different concentration, which we will make it, and then by observe different absorbance, which we can observe in that material. And also different percentage, up to 20% of drug has been released, or 30% of drug has been released or not. We'll check through this kind of things. And similarly, whether this material, like whatever the material which I have been done in the theoretical, practically. So then this material which I had been fitted in the theoretically, and whether this has been suitably fitting or not. So that theoretical models also, there was several models which is nothing but first order, Higgeci and Hexen, and different kind of orders will be there. Theoretical models will be there which we can fit those values in that. So whether it is been suited. So hence what we define is like theoretically as well as experimentally, both will be proving ourselves like. So then we had go for the publications and all kind of things. And one more thing is blood compatibility. So mostly whatever I synthesized material, I just blindly I can synthesize. Yeah, I cannot bluff in front of the people like, yeah, this material is like very good material, very biocompatible material. I cannot say like that. But doing the biological analysis, like different kind of biological analysis, like in vitro drug analysis, in vitro blood analysis, in vitro cell culture analysis, all kind of things which we have to mix together, then only we can go for the publication. Otherwise, the reviewers nowadays, like it will be very difficult to publish a paper kind of things. So what we'll do with the blood, we'll collect those blood from the market, like either from the goat blood or from the some other blood, like so from the human blood and all those things we'll collect. And then we will keep these material of nanoparticles inside the blood. And then, so mostly whatever the foreign material, when we add this in the blood, so clotting appears. Clotting means like blood will clot as soon as it comes outside, like due to the atmosphere and all those things, of the oxygen levels, all of a sudden it will clot over there. Like, so that's all. So that's why we have to do to avoid such kind of things and all, blood clotting and all this. So we have to do these blood compatibility analysis. Like, so different kind of blood compatibility will be there. So one such kind of blood compatibility which I do is like, so we'll do with this in vitro level, like, so UV visible spectroscopy. So there will absorbance value, which we, based on the absorbance value, positive minus negative, and then how much percentage has been occurred. You can see through the, this is the standards which has been observed in the ISTM standards, like internationally approved standards. So this will be approved standards. So whether this material, which should be less than 5%, it should be less than 20% kind of things like. So then only we can say that this material will be the blood compatible material. Kind of. So this is published ACS applied materials and interpersonal kind of thing. And one more thing is in vitro analysis is nothing but the plasma protein analysis. Like, even which we, our body contains several kind of proteins, like, so different proteins. So we'll take those proteins and then we will keep in this material. Whether this protein is being absorbing or not, we will check in that material. So protein, human plasma, so poor platelets has been absorbed on those protein. Whether this protein is being absorbing or not by using this material, nanomaterial. So that we can find out through the UV visible spectroscopy. So that's what which we had done with the, so mostly this protein analysis which I had done at the Italy, like Politecnico di Torino when I was. So there, so we will go with the hospital doctors itself. Like, so there they will contain different kind of like materials, so like blood samples, protein samples and all those things. Like, so there we can find out those things. So this which I had published in the Ceramic International Material Journal and all. And coming to the one more analysis, in vitro analysis, which is nothing but, as I said, so cell culture analysis. So cell culture is very, very important for in vitro range and all kind of things. For example, zinc oxide nanoparticles. So that is very best for the breast cancer cells. Like. And whereas my material, like calcium phosphate material doped with the material, cobalt material. So that material which could be used for the HeLa cells, human vaginal cells, cancer cells. So that could be very much killing the cancer cells without harming the normal cells. So this is very, very important. Like, without harming is very important to kill the normal cells also. Because unless if the normal cells also dies, and there is no use of making those synthesized materials, whatever the materials, right? So that's what we will keep those ratios of the concentration ratios. We have to play a major role with those. The concentration also, even in the PPM range also, it will be very, very be particular with that biological techniques, biological analysis, right? So once if we go exceed with those level also, PPM levels also, then those materials which can, we can see those DEF analysis like figures in that bottom at the HeLa cells, most of the material has been vanishes like, which means that there what I did is like even I had added like 50 milligram, 25 milligram. So with the different synthesis is different, and also how much we have to add in these cells also, that is also a big task in that. So we have to go with the different concentration of the percentage of weight percentage we'll take, and then we will mix in that cell culture material. Okay. And then we'll do with the cell viability through the MTT assay, we can say that like. So MTT assay, so there we can go through, and then 100% of cells has been alive. Like that we can see under the UV visible spectroscopy, and these pictures which we can observe through the optical microscope. And so that we will compare both the results. So either from the, while coming from the UV visible result as well as the telescope through the microscope which we can see under those. So most of the cells has been alive. Like when we go with the normal cells which I had taken here, human kidney cells like. So kidney cells, embryonic kidney cells which I had taken. So these kidney cells is normal, say, acts as a normal cell, and vaginal cells acts as a cancer cells. Like. So these two, I will check with the different concentration of nanoparticles, like 50 milligram, 25 milligram, 100 milligram kind of thing, and then we will keep in that pretty plates. So we have we used to do in the culture plates like. So then we will observe in that material. And coming to this, till up to that, what are all the basic technologies which I had been opted for my research, I had been talked about that. And now I will talk, mainly focus on the areas which I can discuss with those in my published matter, like papers only. So as I said, like a blood compatibility of the iron doped, nano-sized hydroacceptor. So I initial for this paper says that like I had been taken the Fe. So Fe is also very good magnetic property, which has been containing like a so ferromagnetic property Fe ions will have. And then this Fe ions, which I will incorporate in the calcium phosphate, have tight material. Hydroxyapatite and calcium phosphate both are same like. And then we will dope in that, and then we have a different kind of morphology. Initially without doping, so you can see zero Fe. When we can see in the zero Fe, we don't have rod-like morphology kind of things kind of. So only the spherical morphology which we can observe in that like. And when we dope with the different concentration levels, so the rod-shaped morphology which is going to be increasing in that. And then coming to the magnetic structure properties like a diamagnetic. So calcium, pure calcium phosphate shows a diamagnetic property. When we go with the anti-symmetric pattern of those paramagnetic structure, which we can observe for the higher concentration of those. And then which we go with the super paramagnetic material kind of things. And then when we go with the drug release and kind of things like, so when we go with the drug release and how this drug has been released, which here I had been taken only amoxicillin. Amoxicillin is a very good antibiotic medicine like. So amoxicillin, gentamicin and all kind of things like. I'll mix these ion material, whatever the synthesized material into that nanoparticles, drug and like calcium phosphate material. And then I will make a compact material, and then we will keep it in the PBS saline solution. PBS is nothing but the phosphate buffer saline solution. And then we will keep on agitate through the shaker, orbital shaker. And then we're there after shaking with the different time constraints. So we will check the UV analysis, how much drug has been reduced, how much drug has been released in that PBS solution, that we can measure through that UV visible spectroscope. And then, as I said, hemolysis. Hemolysis is nothing but the blood analysis, like blood compatibility analysis. Less than 5% is highly hemocompatible. when we go with the 20%, which is nothing but totally it's like use unused material, like. And coming to the recent publication which I have published in this, a fabrication of the microfluidic material. So there which we had done is we'll take the silicon wafer. So which was silicon wafer which is containing in the circle kind of shape like. So that silicon wafer which we'll do, and we will take with the, when I go with the, we'll go with the photolithography at the nearby institute at South Korea, which is nothing but KAIST, which I can say like. So KAIST is one more organization which is nearer to the, our Chungnam National University when I go. So there I will take those silicon wafer and they keep the photolithography, and with that silicon wafer we'll make a channel kind of that silicon wafer material. And there after finishing that photolithography material, so what we'll do is we'll get that material, silicon wafer, and then we will keep the PDMS, polydimethyltrisilicon. So that is one more polymer which we can coat on that surface of the silicon material. And then this polymer, what we'll do is we will peel out those surface of that silicon wafer. We will separate the polymer as well as the silicon wafer. And whereas here on that polymer, which we can see the microfluidic channel kind of things like. And then what we observe is like we will keep this hydrogel bead. So hydrogel bead, which we can synthesize through the material, calcium material as well as the phosphate material kind of things. And then we will coat those hydrogel bead kind of things. And then we will insert this microfluidic channel. And then there we will pass on the PBS solution through the mortar, pedestal mortar like. We have a small mortar. And then we will keep those sandwich kind of material. So this is polymer material which has a channel kind of things. And another material, a same duplicate which we can make, and then we will both we will fix together like. And then inside what we can observe, the channel kind of things like. Before doing that, fixing these two sandwich material, inside material, we can add a hydrogel bead. So there we can see. These are all the different microfluidic channels which has been already published kind of things like. So next slide, which I can show you those microfluidic channels. So this microfluidic channel, they had been using in the ocular diagnostics like. So they are done with the recently published in the ACS materials. And then they had in vivo level itself, they had approached like. And even in the like food industries and all. So they are mycotoxins in food, they can measure these bacteria kind of things through this one more B figure like kind of things. So there are different kind of materials which we can observe in that. Microfluidic sensors by glucose sensor and pH sensor kind of things they are developed through this material. This is my material which I had focused, which I had, even you can see those figure E. So E is the synthesized material, duplicate analysis, a channel which we had analyzed like. So when we go with the G and H, so we can see those micrographs, optical microscopy, which we can observe. Through the optical microscopy, which we had till up to 200 micrometers range, which had. So those micro bead also which we had. So in one side which we can send the PBS saline solution and by using the pedestal motor. And then from one side to the another side which we can release these drugs and kind of those material. So what we done is like hydrogel bead which has been mixed with the anti-cancer drug. And here which we can observe those drug analysis how much through this hydrogel bead which you can observe. This is the schematic representation which we had published recently, which we had uploaded to this, and which we can see those hydrogel bead, how it looks like. So this is the hydrogel bead, and then we will cut into slices, and then we will go with the optical micro scanning electron microscope. So there which we can observe, so we can see those cubical structures of drug molecules on the drug polymer, hydrogel bead. And there we can observe that during different pH kind of. What we had observed is like our inside our intestine, small intestine, so kind of pH also. So normal body, intestine, that's what like whatever we eat, so that will be easily digest. So in the small intestine, we, that's what it can digest. Then we go with that as consideration, and we took the, not clear, madam?
Now it's okay. Now it's okay, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes. It was breaking your voice.
So, all right. So at different pH, like at different pH, so at pH 5, as well as acidic, pH 5 is nothing but the acidic in nature, like at pH 7.4 is our human body pH. So at point pH 7.4, we took these phosphate saline solution and all those things. When we go with the glucose and when we dehydrate and all those things, basically what they do, saline they will give you. So which means that like a saline and all will maintain the pH at 7.4. And so that drug release which we can observe through these microfluidic channel kind of thing. And then after the drug has been released, so previously which we had observed, you can see those drug molecules, this hydrogel bead before doing the diagnosis. And this analysis is the our bead, this is the bead which after drug analysis, which you can see there is a plain surface on that. You can see in the figure, there is a cuboidal shape of those material, like that material. So material which has containing the cuboidal structure and kind of things. And slowly at particular time intervals, like initially I had taken the four hours, and then I took the drug, I took that channel as a separate, and then after that eight hours I had took that as a separate, different time intervals I had observed those material light. And different time intervals which we had observed. At last, C and F, most of the drug has been eroded, released in the PBS saline solution. So and then, and whether this material, even we had observed the also inside the channel, like so it will be too difficult. So when we inject those cells and all kind of materials in that micro channel kind, so then we initially what we'll do is what we will make it spherical kind of cells inside that, and we will send into that channel, and then finally we will observe a different time intervals, like after day one, how the channel has been looks like. So that and all we can observe in that. So what is the usage of this? Like as I did, like so this usage and all, mostly they can cure at the whatever the application which I had said at particular site. For example, at figure G. So figure G, they are having the lesions and all kind of things. So there at that particular place, we will attach this micro channel, and then the most of the drug has been evaluated at that particular place and with a different time interval. And this is one more thing which I had done during PhD, which we had patented this work, and what we had observed these materials synthesized like hydrothermally, and then after hydrothermally we mix together with the microwave process also. And then these synthesized material give it to the which we had observed those fluorine electrodes. So initially with the laboratory, fluorine electrode similarly like an pH electrode, how we can check with the pH electrode, similarly the same fluorine electrode will be there. The concentration, different concentration which we can measure through this fluorine electrode. And then we will not satisfy with this laboratory level line. And then we will go with the groundwater analysis line. And once if we fulfill these two matches with these two analysis, in vitro level as well as the groundwater analysis, then only we'll go and file a patent like that. So, and up to the 92% of fluorine has been observed from the groundwater through this nano, by using these nanoparticles, by using this nanoparticle kind of things. Right? And then, and this nanoparticles and all, and after the used material also, again we had regenerated. Again, we started doing with the fluorine PPM, different kind of PPM levels, 10 PPM, 20 PPM kind of thing. And again, we will reuse those material. And after regeneration, there will be a 60% of fluorine. Again, it has been removed. So that's what we patented this work with the in the Indian patent kind of. And this is the work which we had done at the Italy. So what mostly which we had done is ceramic material. Ceramic is nothing but alumina, silica, as well as zirconia. So these are all the three different kind of ceramic materials. So which as well as alloys. Alloy materials is nothing but steel, titanium, and niobium. So these three materials will be the bio implant materials, right? So I took three materials of implantation metal materials, alloys, as well as the ceramic materials. And then there we started doing with the analysis, which will be the most efficient to inject inside our body. So this, what analysis we found is like our best adhering of those cells and bone marrow cells, all those kind of things like. So this we had studied with the wettability. Wettability, how we'll do is like a like analysis which we'll do with a droplet. The surface of those ceramic or the alloy material like. And then which we can find out like how the wettability surface, the more wettability will be there so that the more adhering blood vessels, even the blood vessels in the cells adhering has been taken more and more. And this which we had published at the Chungnam National University, like what we done is like so pulsed manner, like this controlled manner, we had synthesized with the silver. Silver is nothing but like an antibiotic material kind of things. So mostly like silver content, which we'll observe like without silver, like mostly ointments and all recently, which we can see the most silver content will be present in that. So antibiotic material. So that's what I just took the silver content material, silver nitrate material, and then I added into the calcium phosphate material. And then I had been taken place with a different drug analysis as well as the cancer cell, as well as the normal cell. So what beauty of this material is like silver and dually doped. Silver as well as iron, a dually doped material, which shows the very good nature of the absorbing material of the earth, as well as the releasing property of the drug has been taken. So this is the drug analysis for this till up to 8 days, which we can see for those material. And this is the blood compatibility. Mostly of the HEK means 293 is nothing but a kidney cells, like normal cells. So you can see the cell morphology even in the higher magnification. Even I had a pictures of 50 micrometer range also with the lower higher magnification. The picture which the lower magnification of 200 micrometer. And then these pictures which we can see in the HeLa, in the below shaped pictures, shows that that indicates that most of the cancer cells has been died. So So has been published in the Material Science and Engineering recently with the collaboration with Chungnam National University and the Southern University. And one more thing which we had done, we had a collaboration with the IUAC Accelerator Center, New Delhi. So there, what we'll do, like, we'll bombard the irradiation taken, we had took with those nanoparticles. And then after irradiating those material, nanomaterial as well as the very good bioactivity so which we had observed through the UV visible spectroscope kind of. So here, similarly, we have different ions, so like silver ion, they can irradiate even gamma irradiation, which we have a collaboration with Dr. K. Ashokan sir. So he is our scientific advisor to since from my PhD and all. So what we'll do synthesize those material, and then we'll took with that New Delhi, and then there do the irradiation material, irradiate different ions. So by using these irradiation properties, they can enhance the activity property of those synthesized. And this has been recently, which we had published, the zinc oxide nanoparticles. So which, plant analysis, like even in the, we had collaboration with the Chungnam as well as my current research place. So there what we can see is that the hexagonal shape of those zinc oxide nanoparticles. So in the 50 nanometer. Range of your those nanoparticles. So there, micro. Yeah, 100 micro. Yeah. So till up to the 100 microgram range, so which has been occur in that, which shows that the very good bio property kind. So this is some of my publications, like this is nothing like patents and all those things. These are all my collaborators. So what I would like to convey is like we always would like to collaborate each other, like whatever either from Radhika madam, through Radhika madam, or we can do with the extensively, so that we can give us better research quality. We will develop the research level with a very good manner. And since we will produce with the different publications. So I will always welcome you for the event. I can help you. Recently, which we have a collaboration with that Tamil Nadu, Madras University, like Varun Padmanabhan, like he is. So we have collaborated. He is a PhD scholar over there. And we had discussed with the scientific journals and all those things. Like we had published in.
Yeah. Is it possible for us to have a collaboration with you? This is CEO talking.
Definitely.
Yes, and we can submit those proposals to DST or wherever it is possible. Is it
definitely,
possible?
Madam.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Definitely, madam. Because
to contact you. Excellent presentation. And we are really impressed. Madam. All your publications. I don't know, it is very, very useful, I think, for the society. And you have opted to help us also. We wouldn't mind collaborating with you and having some useful research. I think you had been doing very useful research, I think.
Yes, madam.
I'm sorry for interrupting you. Continue.
Please. So this is which I had said, like, so he is my professor, like Narakal.
Sir, your voice is not audible, sir. It's breaking, like.
Yes, I was about to say.
My PhD.
Sir, your signal must be weak, I think, sir. Dr. Sharath?
Yeah, madam. Am I audible, madam?
Now you are audible.
Sir, now it is okay. Yes, sir. Previously, your voice was breaking. That's what we want to see.
Oh, all right, madam. Like, so because like now I just connected with the LAN now. So I might have done previous lecture.
Okay.
So that's what So this is my collaborators, like Professor Silvia from the Italy, like Professor Son is from Gwangju University, like Chaosun University. As well as Professor Yang is one of my postdoc, collaborator, which we are continuing our collaboration with their, and recently which we are going to go with Indo and Korean project kind of things we have planning like that, and also with this is one of my scientific advisor or since from my PhD, like Dr. K. Ashokan sir, he is working as a scientist at Inter University Accelerator Center. So Radhika ma'am, with this I'll finish off this presentation. It's a nice being here in this web platform for me.
Yes sir, thank you so much.
And also I would like, I always wanted to collaborate each other and to develop more R&D activities to the society, madam. That's my intention.
Sure, sir. Pleasure is ours. And I request our Chief Executive Officer, Madam Jagdalakshmanan, to address the gathering a few words.
And any other doubts, let them please.
Sure. Participants, you can ask your doubts if you have any. Any doubts, participants?
Sir?
Do you have any doubts?
Yes, my doubt. I'm asking a doubt.
Yeah,
sir?
Please.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, this is about, this is a CEO.
Yeah, ma'am.
I want to know about the quality of research which you had been doing in Italy. You had been there. And what kind of a hurdle you faced in India? Or was it very smooth in both the countries? What is I want your frank opinion, because very often people say in India we are not able to get full support.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's right, madam. That's right. Yes. I'll convey those things, message up. Yes. So what means is that in Italy, or not only in Italy, even in the Asian countries of Korea and all those things, research is our headache. So we have to do hard work. Obviously, whoever will go will do always hard work only, Indians. So there, after going there, so we'll get a lot of freedom for doing research kind of activities. So whereas coming to here, so if we, in India, if you send a proposal, so that it will accept those things, to get a proposal acceptance and all those things, it will be very difficult. That's what, and moreover, even in the abroad, they will have many industries. Industries itself, they will come and give the funding to the universities. But whereas here, there was not much industries which they can come forward and give the fund to the institutions and all those kind of things.
Yes, sir. Yesterday, we were asking a doubt to Dr. Srinivasan of Bardia University.
Hmm.
He was talking about diamond culture. I just, for curiosity's sake, I was asking him, is it possible to do the artificial diamond culture in your lab, sir, kind of thing, I asked him. He said it is very expensive. You need that kind of machineries and things of that kind. Then I asked him, why don't you have a collaboration with the industries who are willing to invest, and academicians can be used to give ideas, and the research contribution can be immediately used.
Exactly.
And he was saying it is not possible in India. Maybe this is possible only abroad, where the industry institute collaboration is better.
Correct.
That's why I asked you also. You went abroad and you did your research. A wonderful research, sir. Your research articles. I mean, I'm an arts person. I didn't understand much of it, but I could see through the practical application of your research. Any research be practically applicable. That's what I will be telling my staff also. And all your research, whatever you have done, medicine point of view or biomedical, any whatever it is, like you have done wonderful research, sir. So people like you must be used even this during Corona time.
Yes.
We have scientists you to do research and develop medicines, all kinds of things. But there should be enough support, I feel.
Exactly.
Maybe you're not given support. That's my feeling. That's why I wanted, because you have experienced it.
Yes.
Students should be, yes.
That's what, like, mainly the students should motivate themselves about the research activities. But whereas in India, the freedom and all, it will comes under in the abroad and all, when I was at Italy and Korea and all. So I used to get 3 undergraduate students, and then I will train them and I will tell them to do so and so kind of things, like. And what they will do is within a week, like within 3 days, not maximum 3 days also, like. So they will analyze the analysis and they will took those data also in front of us. We will, every week we have a discussion with a group discussion with our professor and higher official kind of. Whereas here in India, to get an analysis, it will take months and months, like, which we need to get the funding and all. So that's what we need to get the financial support from, the either from the industries or from the government kind of. So that's what, like, which I was keep trying with the different agencies, funding agencies of DST, DBT kind of things, like. So once if we get those things, and then we can develop a much more R&D activities, like. Not only in very big institutes also, they are all facing for the same problem for getting the funding from the government agencies. Even in the IISs, IITs, even DST, they will get hundreds of proposals, even thousands of proposals per annum. So everything they can't sanction those projects also. Right? So even that, and also there should be a novelty. Novelty should be there in the research kind of things. So that is much more important.
We agree with you, and even the people who are doing research, they must do a really honest research.
Exactly.
And what is the practically useful kind of thing. Sometimes research is done for the sake of research.
Yeah.
And as you said, we are not getting fund also. And government has various kinds of policies, like ours is a self-financing college. And immediately they send a message saying, oh, yours is a self-financing college, we cannot support you. This kind of message really demotivates us. But maybe people like you can help us by having a collaboration with us.
Definitely.
If there are any genuine researches going on in our institution, we can get the help from you. That is why I asked you about that. Thank you, sir.
Sure,
go ahead. Go ahead. These from the students, scholars, please. I mean, he's a resourceful person. You cannot get him immediately. He is willing to answer your queries. Please ask him questions. And you should be motivated to do research. His speech was excellent, and he has really motivated you, I must say. And the way he presented with a high spirit, your spirit of contribution, it was excellent, sir. Really, I was impressed by your
presentation.
Thank you very much.
Anybody has a doubts, they can mail me, and I will always welcome you, and I will help you so that. Our ultimate is to develop R&D activities, research and development. So we will always work together, and then we will develop the research publications or in the research area kind of things. Like.
Yes, sir. Radhika, as sir said, you can get the questions from the students. and send him a mail. That will be better. Maybe we are wasting his time.
Yes, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Yes,
ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you on my behalf.
Thank you, madam.
Sir, also I would like to know whether any consultancy services are available in your institution, like zeta sizer analysis, like that.
Yeah.
Are you providing? What are the analysis we can get, sir?
Yeah, that we can do, madam. Like we don't have in our like pharmacy is having Godavari Institute of School of Pharmacy. So they are having zeta sizer or not, but anyway, if anybody wants to collaborate, so I have the other collaborations to get it done with those zeta sizer or any other analysis kind of things. Like, so since we
sir,
have
you, a collab- sir, you said your commerce department has that.
Yes, pharmacy, okay. Pharmacy
can
department.
You give us some names.
Pharmacy, madam.
Pharmacy, School of Pharmacy.
Okay, pharmacy. I heard it as commerce. Pharmacy. Mm-hmm. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, madam. So there we can done, madam. I can do with the Anna universities or other topmost universities also. We have collaborators, and there we can do those analysis kind of things.
Sir, Madam Chitra has posted a question in the chat box.
Yeah, madam. Let me check the chat box. All right. Thank you. Excellent present. Thank you, madam. Chitra, madam. And so what about the ethical clearance? Ethical clearance is like we need to keep on renewal those ethical clearance, madam. So what they will do is the government hire ICMR people, they will come and they will do with they will check with our labs, they will inspect our labs, and then they will do those whether the facility will be really available in the animal studies. Like, so they have the animal storage room and all kind of things. Like they're supposed to maintain those things, because if for example, like simply they will do research with some mice or rabbit or whatever, simply they will throw those mice and all, that will be very dangerous to the human normal life also. So to clear those things, everything they should clearly maintaining or not, they should check and while checking with the cancer cells and all. Yeah, that was for cancer cells in vitro level itself, ethical issue is not required, madam. So for in vitro, if you want to check those things, when I was in here at Chungnam National University and all, so for checking the cancer cells and all those things, when we have the in vivo level is very important for the ethical clearance and all. Clear, madam?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Clear. Thank very you. Clear. Yes. The person can unmute yourself and tell him whether it was clear to you. Chitra, ma'am, kindly unmute yourself. And yes, you said. Thank you.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You.
Very clear, sir. I could understand that in vitro lab is not necessary to go with the ethical clearance that much. Thank you, sir. Yes. Thank you for an opening.
Thank you.
You can give your feedback on the scholars and the other faculty members. You can give your feedback to sir so that he'll feel happy. With full of energy, he had contributed. I think all the scholars and the faculty members of different institutions, you would have got benefit. So please unmute yourself and give your feedback. And if you want any clear information, we cannot get him each time. This is an opportunity, golden opportunity to you. Such a big scientist, he has come forward to help you. Make use of the opportunity, people like you people, I mean scholars or students or faculty members, please make use of him. Thank you.
Sudarshana, madam, you can go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Requesting the participants to kindly fill in the feedback form before the session gets over.
Thank you is the best prayer that everyone could say. Thanking expresses extreme gratitude. May I now invite Mrs. A. Neelaveni Madam, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, to propose
order.
Thank you, Sudarshana. Good morning, everyone. I hope you join me in such an inclusive valedictory function this morning. I know I am new in the session, but before I let you go in lunch, I will happy to take this as my duty to thank everyone who helped us putting the conference together. I have to make out a situation here in Aspecious. My special thanks to our secretary, Tirupati and Vengarachalam sir, who takes such huge responsibility uplift our rural sector young minds of providing technical and practical knowledge to them in order to attain development. He gave us duty and constant encouragement to organize wonderful conference like this. Thank you, sir, for your great support. A big thanks to energetic and optimistic guide, our CEO, Professor Jagadalakshman, is always being a solid support system and completely dedicated whole span of her time to provide a
balance. Your voice is breaking. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Your voice is breaking. Hold your mic properly. Make adjustments or net problem. I don't know. It's breaking. It's not clear. Make yourself comfortable and the mic should be kept properly. Okay, continue. Continue, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Continue. Okay, thank you, ma'am. A big thanks to energetic and optimistic guy as you, Professor Jagadalakshman ma'am, is always being a solid support system and completely dedicated whole span of her time to provide very valid guidelines and lead loop pathway to us to utilize subject resources by organizing seminars. Thank you, ma'am, for being with us. A special mention and heartfelt thanks to our beloved principal, Dr. Dhanali ma'am, who putting up with all our conference, moreover, who invariable back hold up and gave a pleasant environment for us throughout the moments. Thank you for your presence here. A special mention to our vice principal, Professor Lakshmi ma'am, who creating our pathway to accessible for all our department activities. Endure with valuable suggestions. Thank you, ma'am, for your course to rise up our activities. My sincere thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Sarath Chandra Virla, Associate Professor in Physics, Godavari Institute of Energy and Andhra Pradesh, who conveyed the knowledge about the interactions of material with permeable walls of the closed biological system, including single and subcellular structures, which is important. The interactions between molecules are surfaces dependent on surface functionalization, which is for nanoparticles. Creation and agglomeration have been recognized for cellular uptake and even induced potential uptake based on the nanoparticle composition and cell type. Here, these interactions, a comprehensive knowledge of how nanomaterials interact with biological systems is critical. Today, we have gained more knowledge about the interactions of materials and biosystems. Thank you, sir, for giving us wonderful information about nanomaterials. Deep sense of gratitude to our head of department, Dr. V. Radhika, ma'am, who take our department like a chieftain, guide and illuminate the way for us. And the coordination of faculty members, which leads to great achievements like this. Thank you for this responsibility and coordination change. Our technical supporting teams, Professor C. Anupadi and Professor Priyadarshini, inspire technical assistance for the entire technical house. Thank you, team. A special thanks to the audience and students for their persistent support and coordination. I hope the session gives more knowledge about the biological course and the instructions of the biological assistance. With this warm words and kind message, we move to the end of this today's seminar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for this national conference. Participants can join in the same link by 1:45 p.m. in the afternoon for the fourth session. Kindly fill in the feedback form. Within 15 minutes, the responses will Thank you all.
Thank you, Radhika. It was very nice.
Thank you, ma'am.
Useful and productive. You have organized excellently. And the person is really willing to help us. So you can make use of him in future. Okay, Radhika.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Participants, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.